In this video, I'm gonna show you how to master AI mixing and speed up your creativity. Nothing really has its own place, so nothing's standing out. And it's gonna use AI and make those changes. That's crazy. Honestly, it's wild how it's able to do that. So today we're gonna talk about BandLab's AutoMix feature. And essentially what it does is it balances your volume and panning of the tracks in your project. And the AI has different settings for different genres. So if you're working on a pop song, a rock song, a dance song, you can select what genre it is and it'll base the mixing off of what that genre is usually like. So now that I've explained roughly what it does, I think we should put it into practice and add different elements into our project and then use AutoMix to balance it. So I think we should start a dance track. And to do that, I'm gonna add all of our different samples into the project. Then we'll select dance on AutoMix and have it mix it for us. So first I'm gonna go to BandLab Sounds and add the different samples. To start off with, I wanna choose our chord progression. So I really like the way these samples in the Stutterhouse Cream Pack sound. So I'm gonna click on that and find a really cool sample for our chord progression. And we can go and filter this by what we're looking for. So for me, I'm looking for a loop and I'm looking for a synth. So I'll click synth and then you can scroll through these. So this is exactly what I'm looking for. I'm gonna add that in. So we're not even gonna mess with the volume because we're gonna use AutoMix to do all of that. So we'll go straight to adding the rest of our samples in. Next, I wanna do a synth. So I'm gonna go to Virtual Instruments, go to Leads. I like the way this retro lead sounds. I'll click that. Now I'm gonna record playing the melody in for our synth. I'll hold and select all. Then we're gonna quantize that to the eighth note. Add a slight amount of reverb. Then I wanna add a 16th note delay to this. So we can slide this over and adjust our mix and put that before the reverb. Then we're gonna add a gator to this to help it match the side chaining of those synth chords. So I'll go over, add a gator, select the gate. Next we need to add the bass. So I'm gonna go back into Virtual Instruments and select our bass synth. Next, I'm gonna add our bass sound in. So I'll click record. Same thing, we're gonna hold, select, quantize to the eighth note. Adjust the start and finish time of our MIDI clip. Then we can use a gator to the 16th note to have the bass kind of match the bounce of our synth chords. You'll see if we turn this up a lot, it's intense. But if we back it off a bit, we get that bounce and still some bass coming through. Next, we need to start adding the drums. So I'm gonna go back to BandLab Sounds and I am going to look for a kick loop. Maybe we have something cool in this. I like the way this kick loop sounds. I'm gonna add that in. Next, we need to add more of our percussion in. So I'm gonna go back to BandLab Sounds. Now I'm gonna look for hi-hats. Show results. I think this hi-hat loop will fit nice with our song, so I'm gonna add that in. Move that over to the correct spot. And again, we don't need to worry about the volumes yet because we're gonna use AutoMix at the end to help balance all the volume and panning. Next, I wanna add a clap. So I'm gonna go into BandLab Sounds and look for a clap. So go over, select claps. I think that'll fit nice. Now I wanna add a crash to this so there's some impact at the beginning of the drop. So I'm gonna go back to BandLab Sounds and we're gonna search for a crash. So I'll go cymbal and let's see what comes up. That should work nice. Put that at the beginning. Now I want to hear a bit more texture, so we're going to add some sort of shaker loop to this. So I'm going to go shaker, see what shows up. I think that'll be nice. Then I think we need a simple vocal in here, so I'm going to go voice and audio, turn our auto pitch on to D minor, select a vocal preset.
Tonight, stay.
Now let's record our vocal melody in.
Just stay.
Then on our vocal, I'm gonna use the AI voice cleaner just to get rid of any background noise. That'll clean that up for us and just make it really tight. Now we have this.
Just stay with me tonight.
Now we're gonna add a fill to the end of each section just to give it a little bit of separation from the next. I'm gonna go back into this pack we've been using because I really like how this pack sounds. Whoever made this did a really good job. So I'm going to add this crash in, and then we're going to go over, and I'm going to put this at the end, like this. Then I'm going to slice it. Then we are going to reverse this. And then we'll copy it, paste it here as well. And this will just give us a little bit of suspense going into the next section. And then to complete that fill, we need something that's kind of going to hit only on that last section as well. So we might be able to take this snare loop. Then we can slice this here. Move this part over here. Delete this so we get... Then we can slice here, get rid of this, give us a little swing. I think that sounds really cool. So I'll go and copy that. Then we're gonna paste this here, and I think that's all the tracks we need. And next we're gonna use AutoMix to help mix all 11 tracks together and make it really clean and cohesive. So we have all the right elements to make a really cool dance track, but there's no separation in the mix. Nothing really has its own place. It's just kind of all at the same level, so nothing's standing out. So now we're going to scroll to the left, and you're going to see AutoMix down here. So we can click to expand that, and then there's all the different genres we can choose to help it mix to. And so we can use these different genres to tell AutoMix how we want our song mixed. So if we want it mixed like a hip-hop song, R&B, pop, electronic, rock, lo-fi, house, or jazz, it gives us the option to choose any genre we want for that. So I'm going to select house, and you're going to see these faders are all going to get tweaked. Some are going to be moved up, some are going to be moved down, and it's going to use AI to go ahead and make those changes to the mix to best make our song fit the genre. So now that the AutoMix is applied, I'm going to scroll over and click play and hear how this sounds.
Just stay away with me tonight.
That's crazy. Honestly, it's wild how it's able to do that. Already, it's created so much separation in our mix where certain elements like our vocals can stand out a bit more and not be muddied down by the other elements. And our percussion is hitting and it's really bright. Or maybe we want it to be mixed like a pop track. Click pop, it's gonna further adjust it to be a pop mix. And then we can click play and hear how that sounds.
Just stay away with me tonight.
I honestly think I liked the house mix the best. So I'm gonna go back, select house, and it's gonna go back and mix it like a house record. Yeah, that's crazy. Like, I think I could further refine a little bit and add a bit more reverb to the vocals, but it's gotten me to a place where it's like 80-90% there. Rather than me having to do all of that legwork myself, I can just focus on the little elements that are going to really make the track stand out, like a little reverb or a delay to add a certain feeling that I want for the song, but I'm not having to do all the busy work of mixing it. Because I don't think AI is really trying to take away all of the creative elements for you. It's just taking care of some of the work that's just honestly busy work sometimes. Like, adjusting levels isn't always the most creative decision, and I don't feel like using AI mixing to adjust the volumes is really taking the soul out of my music. It's just taking some of that headache out so I can speed up my creativity and get my ideas down even faster. And so I feel like it's actually just helping me create more ideas, which ultimately I think is a big win for us as musicians, because I feel like the faster I can create a song, the better I can translate what's in my head to actually being a production. Because when I'm slow with my production, I feel like that original idea gets lost a bit. So if I can use a tool like this just to help speed up the process, I think for me, it's gonna help me make better music every single time. And so if we wanna take this a step further and really just polish the auto mix that we had done, what we can do is go below the auto mix and turn on our mastering. Then we can go in and just flick through some of the different presets until we find one that we like. So I'm going to loop our drop. And then I'm going to go over into our mastering and I'm going to click play and just test out some of the different presets. And another thing you're going to want to do before you really mess with the presets is adjust your input gain. And BandLab makes it super simple. You can just click play, select auto, and it'll automatically adjust the input gain best for the mastering presets. So I'll click play, click auto. For us, I think it should be about negative 4.4 dB. This is how fire sounds. It's a lot more bassy, but it's not really as clear as I want the track to be. Let's try clarity. And keep in mind that different presets are gonna sound better or worse on certain styles of music. So one song, maybe clarity sounds great, and on another song, maybe fire is the best preset. It's really just gonna depend on the song. So now let's try tape. Let's try natural. Let's try spatial next. We can also mess with the intensity. I don't know, I think it's between natural and spatial for me. Let's try cinematic. To be fair, it is called cinematic. I'm sure on a lot of different tracks, it sounds awesome. Let's try punch now. This could sound cool considering it's a dance track. We want a track to be punchy. Definitely a lot of compression and limiting going on in this preset. To me, it's pushing the track a little too far. I'm going to try natural and spatial and clarity again and pick one of those three. I think they're the three best ones for this song. So I'll go to clarity again. And before I tell you which one I think is best on the song, I'd be curious in the comments which one you guys like the most, because really it's super subjective. I think a lot of these sound great and there's really no right or wrong. It's just maybe which one you lean towards depending on, you know, what you're into. So for me, spatial I think is the winner. It was really close between universal and spatial, to be honest. Spatial to me gave it a lot of clarity, and I feel like it really made the mix that AutoMix did just stand out even more and kind of highlighted what it did so well for our mix. What's really cool as well is we can go through and we can play the original now and then hear what the mastered sounds like. So this is what the song sounds like with the AutoMix, but before mastering. Then, with the master I chose turned on top of that auto mix we had done, this is what we get. So if you're looking just to speed up the creative process of your music production, I would highly recommend just trying out the AI mixer for yourself and see if it just helps speed up your creativity and workflow. I really hope you found this video helpful and you go out and try the AI mixer for yourself. And as always, happy producing.